Hello, hello, we are here in Gran Canaria, in Western Gran Canaria, and this is the margin of the caldera, the Miocene caldera. It's called the Tejeda caldera, after a village inside the caldera. And here we see the margin of the caldera. It's rather shallow here, it's the topographic margin, and this is where a lot of ignimbrites tried to escape the caldera, but didn't quite make it. So they're pinching out against the caldera's inner wall, or the inner margin of it. There's a ring fault, probably a bit to the left of us, where the real downfaulting happened. But this is where material was shed into, or sucked into the caldera basin, and the eruptions that were trying to escape. And therefore, many of them didn't make it. And that also means that the eruption record is a lot more complete inside the caldera than outside. And then in this marginal area, there was a lot of fluid flow activity along these fractures and boundary areas, as is so often the case in these calderas. And there we had a lot of hydrothermal alteration. This is why the rocks are very colorful. There's intense greens and turquoise color tones and pinks and beige. And this comes from the interaction with hydrothermal fluids at various temperatures, producing partly oxidized, partly reduced domains there. Then what we see is the flat-lying units on top, and that is actually Fataga, that's younger material, younger lava flows and ignimbrites, and by that time the caldera was full, and that's why they can actually top the caldera sequence. If the caldera was active, it would still create space on the left inside the caldera basin. This was obviously not the case. The caldera was filled up, allowing these later units to be in place rather horizontally. And they were also in place after the hydrothermal event, hence they're not hydrothermally altered. Then there's two brown units in there that are actually not altered, and these are later intrusions, also of Fataga age. That would be about after 11 million years, while the hydrothermally altered rocks are about 13 million years, 14 to 13 million years old. So these two intrusions, these two brown areas in there, they are part of the cone sheet swarm. They intruded it after the hydrothermal event. That's why they look different. And of course, that means they are different. So thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed that. And let's zoom in there a little bit, because this is one of the best exposed outer caldera margins that I have ever seen. Thanks a million. All the very best.